Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirajul Afaizi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to talk about freezing point depressions or depression in freezing point. You know my friends, this is a colligative properties. Why it is colligative properties? Because it depends on number of ions and depends on number. So I have already uploaded many videos, means already 3 videos uploaded for you on the basis of colligative properties. So this is the last topic I will discuss in this video, depression in freezing points. So let us start learning of freezing point depressions, that is the colligative properties. You know my friend, normal freezing point or melting point is the temperature at which solid and liquid are in equilibrium under 1 atmospheric pressure. One is very important. People don't remember this one. So remember, 1 atmospheric pressure. Now, additions of solute will decrease the vapor pressure and so will decrease the freezing point. So depression in freezing point means decrease in freezing point. If you go through this picture, this graph, it will clearly show how much differences. This is the del TF. This is del TF. So increase in boiling point and decrease in freezing point. And that is the importance. That is the beauty of the freezing point. Just remember, elevation in boiling point, that is increase in del TB. Del TB is the difference of boiling point and TF is the difference in freezing point. So in order to a liquid to freeze must achieve a very ordered state, and that results in the formation of a crystal. If there are impurities in the liquid, that is solute, the liquid is inherently less ordered. Therefore, a solution is more difficult to freeze than the pure solvent. So, a lower temperature is required to freeze the liquids. Now friends, in analogy to the boiling point elevation, we can calculate the amount of the freezing point depressions using the following formula. And this formula is very important. I repeatedly indicate you, okay, just remember, you have to memorize it. I am not saying everything you just memorize, just to try to understand, try to practice it. Practice, practice, practice will make you perfect. Practice, practice, practice. And always you practice. And if you are passed and if you qualify the MBBS and other competitive examination, you can enjoy. So right now, if you are in class 12, so you just remember this one. Del TF is equal to minus KFM. That is the importance. Negative sign, because the freezing point of the solution is less than that of the pure solvent. That's why it is negative. No, the molality, and I already told you about the molality. Molality is temperature independent. Just remember it. Don't forget. Molality is temperature independent. And temperature is very, very important factor in our life. Now, KF is the molar depression constant that depends on the particular solvent being used. KB of water is equal to 1.86. You know the want of factor and represents the number of dissociation moles of the particle per mole of the solute. So, freezing point depression and boiling point elevation are a direct results of the lowering of vapor pressure. Now, friends, colligative properties. Again, change in vapor pressure, that is the option. The vapor pressure over the solution is lower than the vapor pressure of pure solvent. Just remember, lower. Vapor pressure over the solution is lower than that of vapor pressure of pure solvent. So, vapor pressure of the solvent, P solvent, is proportional to the relative number of solvent molecules in the solution. The solvent vapor pressure is proportional to the solvent mole fraction. So, colligative properties definitions is like that. You can see the colligative properties pictures. You have the here del TAB, del TF. So, I already discussed about the increase in the boiling point, decrease in the freezing point. Now, what will happen? Why it is happening here? Your liquid solvent, triple point of solvent, you know, you can see the pure solid solvent and triple point of solution. You know the freezing point of solution, freezing point of solvent. you know the boiling point of solution, boiling point of solvent, and their difference. So this difference actually will happen with the vapor pressure. So you have the liquid area, you have solid area, you have gas area, and how it is happening here. So just remember it. Now, colligative properties, you know, what is colligative properties? Colligative property depends only on the number of solute particle present, not on the identity of the solute particle. Among the colligative properties, vapor pressure lowering, boiling point elevation, melting point depression, and osmotic pressure. So colligative properties, after studying these sections, students should you know how to explain the effect that a non-volatile substance has on vapor pressure, boiling point, and freezing point. How to determine which solution will have a higher boiling point, lower freezing point, lower vapor pressure based on the number of non-volatile substances. So vapor pressure lowering, boiling point elevation, freezing point depression is the properties of decrease in vapor pressure. Why? The pressure exerted by vapor that is in equilibrium with its liquid in a closed system. Closed system, I am talking about the closed system, that is three different thermodynamics. A solution with a non-volatile substance, one that is not easily vaporized, contains a lower vapor pressure than a pure solvent. When you dissolve salt or sugar into water, the molecules ion are surrounded by water molecules which trap them into the solvent. So therefore, fewer molecules will contain enough kinetic energy to escape the vapor of the liquids. So the difference in temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid phase equals the atmospheric pressure. When a non-volatile substance is added to the solvent, the vapor pressure decreases, so no more kinetic energy has to be added to raise the vapor pressure of liquid. So my friend, this is very important topic, just try to understand. If you understand, then it will be easy for you. I would suggest you go through this video completely. Complete, you can watch this video, then you will understand what is colligative properties. Now friend, depends on the concentration of particle, not the type of particles. It's different concentration, different concentration of particle. Number is important. Now, freezing point depression, you know, difference in temperature between the freezing point of solution and that of the pure solvent. You know, the amount change in freezing point depends on the number of particles dissolved and not the type. I repeatedly saying number is important here. How to explain the effect that a non-volatile substance has no vapor pressure, boiling point, freezing point, and this is the importance. So, friends, how vapor pressure depression occurs? Solute particle take up a space in a solution. Solute particle on surface decrease the number of solvent particle on the surface. Less polar solvent particle can evaporate, which lower the vapor pressure of liquids. So you can see the vapor pressure. The solute molecules are added to a solution. The solvent becomes less volatile. This is important. Make your concept clear. Write it down or not to decrease vapor pressure. Therefore, the vapor pressure of solution is lower than that of the pure solvent. Now go through this picture, you will find vapor pressure, height you can see, solvent alone, vapor pressure now decrease. That is the beauty of the colligative property. You can see the vapor pressure height. In second, if you have the solute plus solvent, though you see the height is decreasing. So vapor pressure of pure water and water solution, vapor pressure of water over pure solvent, water is greater than the vapor pressure of water over aqueous solutions containing a non-volatile solute. So solute particle take up a surface area and lower the vapor pressure. Now, plot slope. The vapor pressure of solution varies directly as a mole fractions of solvent. So Raoult's law I will discuss in my next video. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.